between me and my wife. Why don't you mind your own damn business for once?
Oh, God, Paul, why do you always have to make a scene? Pour me another drink, Henry.
Damn it, Darcy, I just want you to come home.
I'll be home. Later.
I can't believe you'd do this to me, Cook.
Do what to you, Paul?
You smug bastard. You keep away from my wife, goddammit.
You'd better get out of here before you do something stupid.
You son of a bitch!
Don't hurt him, Henry!
Oh gosh, no. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop. Uh-oh, I took them off. I took them off. Oopsies! hang on a second, I'll be right back.
Hey,
alright, reset. There we go. That's
why don't you mind your own damn business
that's better.
For once?
Oh God, Paul, why do you always have to make a scene? Pour me another drink, Henry.
Damn it, Darcy, I just want you to come home.
I'll be home. Later.
I can't believe you'd do this to me, Cook.
Do what to you, Paul?
You smug bastard. You keep away from my wife, goddammit.
You'd better get out of here before you do something stupid.
You son of a bitch!
Don't hurt him, Henry!
This individual's busy? What am I supposed to do then?
Go on. Get out of here.
I'll be at home, Darcy, taking care of our son.
Well, that's dramatic. Dramatic.
Sounds like Ellie needs to talk to us. We should head back to the office next chance we get.
I forgot that happened.
Sorry you had to see that. Things are usually a lot quieter around here. Perfect place to drink, if you're buying.
What was that argument about?
Nothing much. You see, Darcy here likes to relax and enjoy life from time to time, and her husband Paul doesn't. He's not a bad guy, really. Just a little uptight. Too bad he can't learn to relax, huh, Darcy?
Shut up. I don't come here to talk about Paul. You there! I haven't seen you in here before. Why don't you make yourself useful and buy me a drink or something?
You come here often?
As often as I can. Henry is so good at listening to my troubles.
Troubles? What would you know about that? Anyway, I got a bar to run. Ordering?
So is this your place?
That's right. Owner, bartender, sympathetic ear. I try to provide a little oasis from the hardships of life. Name's Cook, by the way. Henry Cook. Let me know if I can get you anything.
Right,
gonna pass.
Then.
Gotcha.
You're in the only spot worth going to around here.
Alrighty then. So that was an exciting way to start this off, wasn't it? Yeah. I probably should have just done that for the last video, but I figured I should probably do that at some point, so. That's just the first part of that. That's a pretty long quest, so I'm not gonna do it right away, but meh. Anyway, so hello and welcome to this video
today's
where
Halloween.
We continue.
But do we get treats? No.
It's Halloween today? Oh gosh, yes, we gotta check that out. Whoops. 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 And we learned that I am a klutz. That's what we learned. See, there's two holidays that this entrance is decorated for, Halloween and Christmas. It's Halloween in game, so happy Halloween! But yeah, they also have voice stuff too. Christmas is really cool because there are lights and stuff everywhere, Christmas lights, and I love it. I love it so much.
Oh, wow, you're tall.
Yeah, even though Nick seems about as tall, if not taller than me. Alright, so we're just gonna continue story stuff for now. And talk to Piper. Get her thoughts and opinions on what we should do. Even though I already know what these are.
Well, well. The Nikki Valentine walks into my office for a change.
What can I say, Piper? You, me, and hard luck all seem to run together like acid rain down an old sewer.
You, including your client here in that analogy?
You should.
You two are finally letting me in on this little case of yours. What's the story?
Finally? You were traveling with me, like, the whole time.
We need help, Piper. This man named Kellogg kidnapped my son.
I made him a little bit more fashionable, if you couldn't tell.
With the Institute. He gave them Shaun.
The Institute. Oh, boy. I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Yeah.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Shaun.
Kellogg. Huh.
Man like that would have had access, in and out.
But we both know that angle isn't going to work.
Yeah. Any other ideas, Nick?
Talk about a literal dead end, huh?
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
I was so blinded by anger. I just wanted him dead. Now look what I've done.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Goodneighbor called the Memory Den.
Yep.
Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened.
Yep.
If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
I hope you're right, Nick.
Let's see. I guess we're gonna need a...
I love how a good idea translates to, I hope you're right, Nick.
To bring to Amari and find out okay. If this is gonna work.
Jesus, Nick. Gross. Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads. Nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so...
What? We definitely could. It would be great. That would be my dream right there. Just like me, Nick, Piper, and Hancock all traveling down, hon. Just the Commonwealth. Oh, man. Oh, yes. Yes.
It's you and me, Nick.
Let's get going. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
While you two are out, I'm gonna do some more research. I'll be here if you need me.
Alrighty. And we started this. Woot. At some point I want to get, in the relative near future, I want to get Hancock as my companion, which requires me to do a quest that's not my favorite, but I'll still do it because Hancock, that's all I need, right? Why are there Voltec lab coats? Alright, Nikki, let's head to Goodneighbor. I guess I can fast travel there, huh? Yeah, let's do that. I always get lost on the way to Goodneighbor. I don't know why, but I always do. So let's just fast travel. That'll be a better idea.
Even good people. Scared. That'd be Diamond City's motto.
Yep, that's accurate. Goodneighbor. Free your mind. It's so weird getting all these story related loading objects. Because at the part where I'm at, it's usually just enemies or... Yeah, it's pretty much just enemies, I'd say.
Good neighbor. Lowest place in the Commonwealth. Everything not nailed down rolls through here at some point.
That's pretty accurate, actually, yeah. Alright. Come on, Nick. Let's go in Memory Den.
Brotherhood of Steel. Better stay out of Good Neighbor.
Oh man, I'd love to see that. Good people of Good Neighbor versus the Brotherhood of Steel. Could you imagine that war? Dang, that would be amazing. I now want to see that. So that's all I can think of now. Paladin Dance versus oh man. Yes, I need that in my life. I need that to happen somehow.
Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have
Nick.
Let's go talk to Amari.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
I was trying to get the cinematic type thing going, but instead I just interrupted Nick. Sorry, I'm rude, I know this. Didn't mean to. Oh my goodness, Nikki. Okay, actually I'm walking slower than Nikki.
Dr. Amari?
Yes? Wait, I remember you. The memory inducement. Vault 111, right? What's this all about?
You're the one who can extract memories from a brain, right?
Normally, we only allow our clients to experience their own memories. Now, what's this all about?
We need a deep dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you two mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse. You don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's an incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
Nikki.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right, let's do this.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine.
Start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Is Nick gonna be okay?
Yes, the connections appear to be stable. Hopefully,
that's all I care about right there. She's like, Nick, are you alright? Are you sure? I really don't want to do this to you, Nick. Please. I don't know, like, Oh, especially with my first playthrough, just like Nick was like the friend I made in the Commonwealth. Like, he's the person that's just, he is my companion.
While your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
All right, let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
I love it. And let's hope.
See you on the other side.
I really want to know how this works. Like, do the memories just appear on the screen, or do we get so immersed into it that we just, it just seems like it's actually happening? I don't understand.
It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
They might not be stable. Well, yeah. Alright, this is gonna take a while because it's very story driven and yeah.
Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
This is so weird. This is like completely different from like the whole entirety of the game, which is kind of cool.
Turn down the goddamn radio! I'm trying to sleep!
Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though. Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole. Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but she loved me in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left. I didn't want to know. Not then.
What a joke.
What's it mean, Mom?
Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe.
Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days. Like, before the big war.
Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless. But you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio, all useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
No kidding, you couldn't get that from
there
earlier?
There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence.
I'm
there.
Going.
Try that one.
Yeah, I can't run. I have to walk.
The thing about happiness is, is you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. Focus on that petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like.
It's gonna be...
I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
You'll see.
Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second.
Some of these things I'm not accessing. I'm just accessing the ones pretty much on the people.
Sarah, you gotta give it a chance.
Just cause it's gonna be really long then otherwise.
Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
No, I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kinda green.
I know, but that's where I'd come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
They sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe.
I wanted that gun! I tried looking for it. Apparently it's supposed to be there.
I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got it.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
How did you think this was going to end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself. There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. They just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end, one way or another. I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
So, I hear you'll take care of people. Is that right?
If you pay me. Oh, we'll pay you.
And you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
I know it's trying to humanize Kellogg's character, but at the same time, just like, oh, okay, man. I mean, it kind of works, but at the same time, just like, okay. His actions at the Mr. end.
I'm glad
horrible.
You decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute.
It's...
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed. And I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Which suited me just fine. I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't going to be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
Come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I can see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
I still want that gun.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something.
Come on.
We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly...
I think this is like the last
connecting
one.
Now.
Well, actually, there's two more, because there's still this one, and then there's the important one.
I'll try to locate another memory as quickly as I can. Please try to remain calm.
The eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me, and I made sure they knew it.
Checking through the logs.
I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really.
It's all
just find them.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
The other people were alive at that time.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long. I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of, her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but,
I'm glad you included that line right there, yeah.
Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
You're real sure about that? You're really sure about that?
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come here. Come here, baby.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Shaun!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here. Let's go. At least we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup? I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again.
Oh, I mean, third time at least. This time it just kind of gets nulled.
Whenever you're ready.
All right, here we go.
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory, so...
I always love how that generates the looks based on whatever your main character is.
Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family. I ended up... This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
X688,
okay. One of the new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter, stronger, and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
Get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow.
Let me just pull this out of nowhere. Here you go.
Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
It's all over, but the dreaming.
X688, ready to relay with Shaun.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
I'm ready. Pull me out, Doc.
Okay. I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage.
And what about Nick?
Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
We got what we needed. The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out.
Yes. Their greatest secret has finally been revealed. But that only leads to more questions. How does it work? Where do we go next?
Virgil?
That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation and the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak. A way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same. If you're going to follow him.
Yeah, of course I'm going to follow him.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck. And be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Nikki! Nikki, I'm coming! Nikki.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. I was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
We have to head into the glowing sea. Any advice?
I'm a synth, so radiation isn't much of an issue for me, but an old suit of power armor might just be the guardian angel you're looking for. That, or you could buy up all the Rad-X and Rad-Away you can find from any chem dealer who's got it in stock.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far.
No
Let's
kidding.
See where it takes us next.
Alright, well, that was very long and took a long time, and I'm sure you don't want to watch it anymore, so thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I know this one's a little bit harder to get through because it's a lot of story stuff, but thank you, and I hope you somewhat enjoyed it. So, yeah, I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.